Hi everyone.
This week I have come up with the chapter IUPAC Nomenclature Rules of Organic Compounds. This video is helpful for all the students for IIT JEE, for NEET and for the ICCBC board exams. Before proceeding with the rules of the nomenclature, let us understand the syntax. How do we name the organic compounds? In what framework do we name the organic compounds? First is prefix. Next, we write the word root. Then we write the primary suffix. And then we write the secondary suffix. Now let us one by one understand that what these terms mean. Number one is word root. Word root, it indicates the number of carbon atoms. Present in an organic compound, or we can write hydrocarbon. If the number of carbon atom is 1, then we write word root as meth. For 2, we write it eth. 3, prop. 4, bute. 5, pent. 6, hex. 7, hept. 8, oct. 9, non. 10, dec. 11, undec. Dodec. C20 is icos, and C30 tripont. Now we come to the prefix part. What is prefix? Prefix means whatever we write before a name, pehle. Okay, so in prefix we indicates, it indicates the saturation, it indicates the substituents. It indicates the substituents present in a compound. Substituents indicate the alkyl groups in substituents. We can have alkyl groups or functional group other than the principal functional group. Principal functional group is the main functional group. So any functional group which is present at a lower position in the Snoyer table can be named as a substituent, and there are some substituents which are always named as a substituent. There are some functional groups which are always named as a substituent. So those substituents are fluorine, we term it as fluoro, chlorine, we term it as chloro, bromine, bromo, iodine, iodo, NO, nitroso, NO2, nitro. These functional groups are always named as a substituents. We write them in prefix. Now in prefix we have substituents which are alkyl groups also. Suppose I am writing methane. If I remove one hydrogen, it will become methyl. So methyl act as a substituent. Suppose it is ethane. We remove one H, it become ethyl. If it is propane, again remove one hydrogen, it will become propyl. If I write this as a substituent, then this is a isopropyl. Now this is a having a particular skeleton. Here also you can see there is CH3. Here also there is one CH3. And this is a 3 or 2 degree carbon. Okay. But if it will have only CH3 and CH2 on both the sides, then this skeleton will have a prefix iso. If I am writing CH2, CH3 and CH3. This will be named as isobutyl. Again, you can see this is a skeleton CH3 and CH2. Same skeleton is there, but 4 carbon chain. So I will again use iso, but it will become butyl because it's a 4 carbon chain. Now I'll show you with the sec one. Suppose this is a substituent. This is CH3. This is CH2. This is CH3. Now this is not the same. This carbon is a 2 degree carbon, but the skeleton is not same. So in this case, we'll use the word sec butyl. If we have 3 degree carbon and if that is used as a substituent, then this is a tert butyl, 3 degree carbon. If it's 5 carbon chain and same skeleton, but if it's becoming a 5 carbon chain, then here in this case we use the prefix as neopentyl. So this is the difference between the different prefixes we use, iso, sec, tert and neo. I hope these confusions are now clear. Now you can easily understand where to put sec, where to put tert and where to put neo. Now there are some functional groups, if they are present at a lower position in Snoy table, they are named as a substituent in a polyfunctional compound. So there are some functional groups. Used as substituent in a polyfunctional compound. A compound having more than one functional group. In that, if OH is there, then we use hydroxy as prefix because it is used as a substituent. If it is SH, we'll use mercapto. If it is COOH, we'll use carboxy. If it is CN, then we'll use cyano. If it is NH2, then here we will use as amine. If we are having C double bond OH, here we will use formyl or aldo. If we have a ketone, then here we will write oxo or keto. With a COCl, then we will use chloroformyl. If it is C double bond O NH2, then here we will use carbamyl. So here NH2 we will use amino as prefix. Now we are done with this prefix. Now we will come with the suffix part. In suffix part indicates the unsaturation or saturation present in the compound, plus the main functional group present in the compound. Unsaturation or saturation represents the primary suffix, and main functional group represents the secondary suffix. So in primary suffix, unsaturation or subsaturation, if we are having all single bonds, then it is alkene. Suffix used is ene. If you are having double bond, then there is an unsaturation. The suffix used is ene. If there is a triple bond, again unsaturation. Suffix used is ine. In secondary suffix, we use main functional group. If it's alcohol, then we'll use all. If it's aldehyde, then we'll use al. If it's acid, then we'll use oic acid. If it's ketone, then we'll use on. C double bond O, Cl, then we'll use oil chloride. If it's C triple bond N, then we'll use nitrile as suffix. If it's SH, then we'll use thiol. If it is an ester, then we'll use an OH. If it's amine, NH2, then we'll use amine. Now, here there's one more key rule which you need to note. If you're writing suffix, primary suffix, suppose ene, suppose this is a compound CH3, CH2, OH. So first, this is the numbering you will do, 1 and 2. First, we'll write the prefix. There is no substance, so no prefix will be there. Then we'll write what? Word root. So word root is 2 carbon, so we'll write eth. Then we write the suffix, which is the primary suffix, saturation or unsaturation. It is a saturated, so we'll write ene. And then we write the main functional group. Functional group OH is present in the one position. So ethene, one, all. But this is not the correct name. When we are using the primary suffix and the secondary suffix, and in both the cases, if both the words are vowel, then this E of the primary suffix gets dropped. So the correct name will be ethene, one, all. Or we can simply write ethanol. Okay, so this you need to remember, that when there is the vowel in the primary suffix, at the end of the primary suffix and at the beginning of the secondary suffix, then the E of the primary suffix gets dropped out. And we write the name in this way. E is not written. This is the incorrect name. This is the correct name for this compound. So with this, I have finished up with the syntax of the nomenclature of organic compound. How do we write the organic compound? How do we name the organic compound? First, we write prefix, then word root, then primary suffix, and then secondary suffix. In prefix, we indicate the substituents. It can be the alkyl substituents or the functional groups which are not used as a main functional group. In word root, we indicate the number of carbon atoms in the organic compound. In suffix, there are two things, primary suffix and secondary suffix. In primary suffix, we indicate the unsaturation or saturation. And in secondary suffix, we write the main functional group. So in this video, I have just explained you the syntax, how to write the name of the organic compound. I hope you like the content of the video. If you like the content of the video, then please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.